We shall take a look at the solution to the evaluation of an arithmetic expression or writing the logic using an algorithm to evaluate an arithmetic expression. So let's first try to understand the problem. Y is a function which depends upon the values of x and n. So if n is equal to 1, y is 1 plus x. If n is equal to 2, y is 1 plus x upon n. And if n is equal to 3, y is 1 plus x to the power of n. For any other values of n, y is 1 plus n into x. So if you look at the problem, it is very clear that we need three variables. One is y, one is x, and one is n. We are not going to ask the user to enter the value of y because we are going to calculate y based on the value of x and n. So you read the value of x and n. Now the first time you are going to check is n equal to 1. So if n is equal to 1, what you are going to do here is, we are going to say y is equal to 1 plus x. Okay, this is the first time we are doing it. So if n is equal to 1, y is 1 plus x. Then the second possibility is n is equal to 2. If n is equal to 2, then y is 1 plus x divided by n. Bracket is not required, but I have just put it so it's really clear. Then if n is equal to 3, okay, then y is 1 plus x into x into x, because whatever is the value of x, it is to the power of 3, so I am multiplying it by 3. And for any other value of n, I am going to say y is, okay, for any other value of x, I am going to say y is 1 plus n times x or n into x, and step number 4, I am going to print the value of y. Now in order to gain understanding of this particular logic, we shall simply run a test that makes it really easy to know whether we are right or wrong. So what we'll do is, let's say x is 7 and n is 2. So we read x is 7, n is 2. Is n equal to 1? This is false. Else if n equal to 2, this is true. So y is 1 plus, okay, x by n, okay, this is 3.5 plus 1. So this should be 4.5. This is a correction from my side, because you are going to add 1 plus x by n. Now, next step. Okay, so after this is done, neither of these are true, so it will come print the value of y as 4.5 and then it will stop. So you need to understand in an if, else if, else if, else. If one of the condition is true, the other blocks will not get executed. Since this was true, n was true, neither this nor this nor this got executed or produced any output. Now let's take an example of one more. Here x is 10, n is 11, we need to calculate the value of y. So x is 10, n is 11. This is false. This is also false because n is 11. 11 equal to 3 is false, else. Now this is 11 into 10 is 110. Again, I missed this, so it should be 111. So 111 will be the value of y, which will be printed on the output screen. So this is a simple problem, just tells you how to use if, else if, else if, and else. Important thing to understand, if one condition is true, it will not go to the other parts at all.